More than 3 million years ago, our ancient human ancestors, including their toddler-aged children, were standing on 2 feet and walking upright. Well, we know all about Lucy, but what about Lucy's baby? Let us meet the earliest baby girl ever discovered. 3.3 million years ago, the fossils of a 3-year-old girl was discovered in Ethiopia, in an area called Dikika. Though a baby, she provides researchers with a unique account of our past. The fossilized remains of this 3-year-old early human child are often referred to as belonging to Lucy's baby, since she was found only a few miles south from where Lucy was found over 2 decades earlier, even though the child's fossil is actually 100,000 years older than the famous Lucy. The new find consists of a skeleton of the earliest and most complete juvenile human ancestor ever found that lived 100,000 years before Lucy and was found in an area called Dikika in Ethiopia by a paleoanthropological team, the Dikika Research Projects, led by Dr. Zerasene Elesmet of the Max Planck Institute. She is nicknamed Salem after the Amharic word for peace, which is Ethiopia's official language, and is the most complete early human child known up until Neanderthal times. First piece of the baby was found on December 10, 2000, but recovering the partial skeleton required intensive searching and sifting over 4 successive field seasons between 2000 and 2000. Prior to Salem's discovery, researchers knew very little about early human growth patterns, as the early human fossil record consists of few children. What made the researchers so happy were that her partial skeleton is made up of a nearly complete skull and torso and several limb bones. Her legs indicate she could walk upright, but other skeletal features showed she could also climb trees. The hyoid bone beneath her neck looks ape-like, and her gorilla-like collarbone and long curved fingers show significant tree climbing. Her completeness, antiquity, and age at death combined makes this find unprecedented in the history of paleoanthropology and open many new research avenues to investigate into the infancy of early human ancestors. Because Salem's baby teeth erupted in a pattern similar to a 3-year-old chimpanzee's, researchers now know Australopithecus afarensis children shared a chimpanzee's fast growth rate. The brain size of the Dikika girl is estimated at 330 cubic centimeters, which is not very different from that of a 3-year-old chimpanzee. However, when compared to the adult values of its species, the Dikika baby had formed only between 63 and 88% of the adult brain size, which is lower than that of chimpanzee, where by the age of 3, over 90% of the brain is formed. This relatively slow brain growth observed in Australopithecus afarensis is slightly closer to that of humans, pointing to a possible behavioral shift in the species that lived 3.2 million years ago. Belonging to the species Australopithecus afarensis, when scientists discovered this 3.2 million-year-old skeleton of a child of the human lineage in 2000 in the village of Hedar, Ethiopia, they were able to study growth and development of Australopithecus afarensis. The scientific significance of the new find is multifold, contributing substantially to our comprehension of the morphology, body plan, behavior, movement and developmental patterns of our early ancestors. Like Lucy, the fossil child was a member of the species Australopithecus afarensis, pioneers of upright walking. Yet her ape-like shoulder blades hint that our forebears may have taken longer than we thought to fully come down from their trees. The result is a creature whose upper body was ape-like, but whose pelvis, legs and feet had familiar human-like adaptations, and 21 years later, the 3.3 million-year-old fossilized skeleton known as Dikika baby remains one of the most important discoveries in archaeological history, one that is filling in the timeline of human evolution. Though he has been studying Salem for nearly two decades, Alamsek thinks the fossil has more secrets to share with the modern world. He also said that there were other bipedal species before, but what is making this unique is the preservation of the spine, which simply is unprecedented. Not only is it exquisitely preserved, but it also tells us that the human type of segmentation emerged at least 3.3 million years ago. It might not seem that important to all, but figuring out when the tree-to-ground trunk took place is immensely important to understand how we became who we are. Bipedalism, after all, gave pre-humans a literal heads-up on approaching predators and freed up our hands for stone tools, which in turn gave access to more types of food, among other advantages. And with that, we have come to the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and do let us know what you thought of it in the comment section down below. For more videos like these, check our channel out, and please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.